Signals are now a core concept in the Angular framework. When you build components, directives, and services, you're going to want to use them going forward. And as you do, at some point, you'll likely ask yourself the question, how can I create a signal based on the values from another signal? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how, and it won't take very long either. For the examples in this video, we'll be using this simple photo sharing application for a fake company called PetPix. The idea is that folks can use this application to share interesting images of their pets with other animal lovers. The area that we'll be focused on will be down here where people can purchase a print of the photo. We need to wire up the shipping and handling value as well as the order total because, as you can see, when we switch images, the price is the only data that changes. So, let's take a look at the code to see what we'll need in order to pull this off. For the display of this purchase region, we have a purchase form component. If we open up this component, we'll see that right now, it's a really simple component. There's not much to it. All it has is an input for the price of the photo. Now, let's look at the template real quick to understand what we're currently displaying. Here we have a table of data with a row for the price using the string interpolated value of our price input. And then for the shipping and total data, we just have the zero values hard-coded right within the template. To fix this, we are going to create a couple of new signals for these values. And to create these signals, we will be using the computed function. This function allows us to create a signal based on the values of other signals. And its value will be automatically updated every time any of the signals used within are updated. Let's start by creating a property for the shipping and handling value. First, we'll add a new protected field. Let's call it shipping. Now we'll set its value by adding the new computed function. This function requires a parameter of a computation function. This function will need to return the value for our signal. To create this value, we are going to multiply our price input value by 0.085 or 8.5%. Then we'll use the toFixed function to round this value to the nearest two decimal places. And that's it. Now we can switch over to the template and replace the existing content with the string interpolated value of our new signal. There. Now let's save and see how we did. Nice. Looks good. And as we switch between the images, we can see that the value is properly updated too. Okay, now let's create a signal for the total using our price input and our new shipping signal. To do this, let's add a new protected field called total. And we'll set its value just as we did with the shipping value using the computed function. We'll take the value of the price and we'll add the value of the shipping signal. But for this, we'll need to convert it to a number, which we can do with the number function. And then just like the shipping signal, we'll round it to two decimal places with the toFixed function. Okay, that should be all we need. So let's update it in the template now. Okay, now let's save and take a look. Nice. Now we have the total value too. And it looks like it properly updates as we switch through the images. Pretty cool, right? Now, not only is this a pretty slick way to do this sort of thing, but there are some key performance benefits too. For one, computed signals are only calculated when the value is needed, so the first time the value is read. Computed signals are also memoized too. So once the value is read for the first time, it's then cached, and then the next time it's read, it will return the cached value. So they're pretty cool all around. Okay, I guess that's all for now. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, check out my channel for more videos about various topics and features within Angular. Until next time, thanks for watching.